Hello, guys, and welcome back. Top 8's about to start right now, but we do have your guys' top 8 list. Deck list. Mm-hmm. And, all right, go ahead, name it from 1st to 8th or 8th to 1st.
Let me see. Let me pull up the the photo. Trying to do this real quick before they sit down. Our illustrious judge, William Kim, is discussing things with them. So from 8th going up, we have Omar Martinez in 8th place, Hunter Bolding in 7th place, Bryant Young in 6th, Andrew Son in 5th, Jace Morrison in 4th, Lafayette Kinsey in 3rd, Vidianto, I can never say his last name properly, Vidi, in 2nd, and a young Stephen Lee in 1st place. And we're going to first feature Hunter Bolding versus Vidi. Hunter and Vidi, let's get their deck list. Here's Vidi. I don't know.
But Vidi, he is on. He's on Phoenix.
On Phoenix?
Yeah.
Which type of Phoenix?
Blue red Phoenix.
That blue red?
Yeah, he has 4 arc lights, 4 thingy eyes, 2 crackling jakes, 2 Terramanders, 1 young pyromancer, 4 scalding tarns, 3 islands, 2 mountains, 1 flood strand, 1 misty. 3 steam vents, 4 spire of love canals, 4 ops, 4 serum visions, 4 thought scours, 4 faithless looting, 1 lightning axe, 1 flame slash, 4 metamorphos, 1 surgical extraction, 4 lightning bolts, and 2 gut shot.
Interesting. Hunters are humans.
Ooh.
A deck that we've heard about. heard about humans? Haven't seen all day. He is running. We're going to bop over to the feature match while I read this off to you guys. To you all here. He's got 4 champions of the parish, 2 Kessig Malcontents. It's a hot piece.
Nice.
3 Kaisel Freebooters, 4 Mantis Rider, 4 Meddling Mage, 4 Noble Hierarch, 3 Phantasmal Image, 4 Reflector Mage, 4 Thalia Guardian of Thraben, 4 Thalia's Lieutenant, and 1 Tajik Legion's Edge mainboard.
Like
the typical 19 lands for Aether Vial. And then we'll talk about sideboards when we go into game 2.
Nice. So, who has the upper hand here?
Man, it's hard to say. Blue-red Phoenix has Thing in the Ice, and that card alone is a pain in the butt for humans.
Yeah.
And that other little card, the Petamanda.
Yeah, Petamanda.
Which I heard what's-his-name say it that one time. Yep, I need to type in the info. The Terramander. Someone jokingly said it on coverage, GP coverage.
Terry?
As Petamanda.
Oh, Petamanda?
Yeah.
I call him Terry Terramander.
Young Terry.
Yep.
Hunter on humans. Hunter repping the humans.
And this is actually, Vidi's actually trying to hopefully get either first or second so he can get a bye.
Yeah, this will be.
He's already queued for the CSQ.
Mm-hmm.
But if Vidi does keep going on and gets to the final, if he gets to the final, he will end up getting a bye.
That is correct.
So that's pretty good for Vidi. All right, there it is. So, I'm gonna be honest with you. I hope Vidi gets it. You're a humans player, so I know you're going for the humans player, right?
Yeah, dude. Screw Phoenix decks.
Yeah, I'm not a Phoenix. I don't really like Phoenix decks, but you know, it is what it is. Ooh, let's see what's going on. What's he looking for?
Let me take a look real quick. See who's on play draw. I believe Vidi is the higher seed. Yep, because he is second in the standings, so he will be on the play.
Nice. All right. Hope you guys had a good break. We know me and James did.
Yeah, dude, we went and got some Chinese food.
And I'm ready, yep.
Kind of ready for a nap. Here comes Vidi.
You or me?
No, you.
Okay, sorry. Vidi starts off with his Scalding Tarn. He's going to go ahead and fetch. He's going to go to 19.
Oh, they might be waiting to see if our illustrious judge, William MF Kim, actually said to go yet.
I think he's just getting his writing stuff down.
Oh, almost knocked the deck.
Yeah.
Good catch. Oh, yeah. Should probably put the sideboard away.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah. He's going to go down to 19.
No. 19. Is 19 good enough for you?
And is he just gets a basic here? Oh, no. Actually, he's shocking. He's going to go down to 17. Who's over here screaming?
I was going to say, it sounds like Carlo, but I know he's not here.
Yeah, Carlo's not here. And he's going to go ahead and play the Serum of Visions. Draws a card, scries two. Trying to see. Ooh, look at those lightning bolts. Those are nice.
Oh, there's people playing Super Smash.
Yes.
We need to ask them to not smash so loud, actually.
Yeah.
I'll handle that. I'll be right back. I'm really good at yelling at people. If you can handle the commentary
for a moment. I got this. Go ahead. Let me know if you want me to scoot in or not. Am I good? Okay. And Hunter plays the sword. My sword's the Plowshares. I'm sorry. Champion of the Parish. Passes over back to Vitti. Vitti draws a card. He's going to play a island. Doing some little bit of math here. And there's a thing in the ice. Pass his turn. He's going to go home and play Horizon Canopy. And tap for two. He's going to ping himself. He goes to 19. And he's going to go ahead and play a Thalia. Guardian of the Thraven, which is pretty good. Because now all the Vitti spells are going to cost one.
An additional one.
An additional one. Sorry.
That is correct. Thalia, Guardian of Baden.
Thraben. Maiden, yeah. Thraben. Thraben. Thraben.
Bay of Thraben.
All right. So, what does Vitti do from here now?
Vitti's going to want to get rid of Thalia ASAP. That typically seems to be what these Phoenix players do.
So, the cool thing about this is even if he gets rid of the Thalia.
Dude, a Misty Rainforest?
Mm-hmm.
He got green in his deck, too?
No, I think he's just has that fetch just for the
all
fetch.
The fetches, yeah.
He's going to go ahead and... You good?
I fucked it up. Messed it up.
He's going to Lightning Bolt the Thalia. And then he's going to play the... And then you remove a counter from Thingy Ice. Mm-hmm. And then... You just play the opt now?
He might save opt for later. If he's got the Peter Mander. Yep.
There it is. Peter Mander himself. We're going to see Reflector Mage for Hunter here.
Does he have the third mana source?
Oh, yeah. Well, you're right. He has to have the third mana source. And he does not have a mana source. That sucks really bad.
He's going to take another one. Go to 18.
And there's the Thalia.
Thalia's Lieutenant.
Swinging for four, right?
Yep. Swinging in for four. Vitti does not want to make this trade because it means he won't be able to flip thing. Odds are he'll be able to flip thing this turn.
Crackling Drake seems pretty good right now. It doesn't look that good for a Hunter right now. If he can he flip Thing in the Ice right now? Three spells. He can opt. Yep, we're going to see the opt now.
Yeah, and Vitti really doesn't mind if he does flip thing, and because I'm pretty sure the Pizza Mando is, I cannot say it like that.
Pizza Mando? Pizza Mando. Oh, there goes Manamorphose. He's only one away. He has two mana. Ooh, and he's gonna whiff here, I think. Swings in for one. Goes down to 17.
I think he just wants to set it up.
So hopefully Hunter hits a land here, and he does, and we're going to see Reflector Mage. He's going to stop Thing in the Ice here, which is pretty good. And humans, looks like, bam, there it is. Goodbye, Thing in the Ice. Won't see you until two turns.
Mm-hmm.
And this is swinging for 5, 6, 7.
Pretty great for Hunter here.
Yeah, Thalia also gets a counter, because when a human enters, he gets a counter, correct?
Thalia's Lieutenant, yes. As did Champion of the Parish.
Yeah.
He took seven. Yeah. The dice is just out of view there.
So he's at seven, I think.
No, he's at five.
He's at five. I think this could be it for Vitti. Unless he... No.
He could play Drake, draw a card, and Drake's pretty big. Drake's going to represent a lot of power, but that's not doing much. So...
Well, he's going to trade with the champ. Oh, no. Okay, so this is what he can do. Yes. has fantastic image.
Here's Lance. He's going to name Illusion. He's going to copy. Yep, as you were saying. Sorry.
Yeah, sorry. Reflector Mage. Mm-hmm. Targeting the.
He's going to copy. Copy Reflector Mage.
Oh, no. He does. Oh, he can still do it. Yeah. No, yeah. This is lethal itself. And there is a Phantasmal Image. Yep. That's going to do it here. Game one.
But he's just going to scoop it up.
Yeah. Hey, you called it.
Yeah, if you can deal with Thing in the Ice, you can win the game. Yeah. But Thing in the Ice is really the number one card in the Blue Red Phoenix that humans just has to deal with, or else it suffers and loses.
Let's go to sideboards.
Yeah, let's check them out.
You should do humans. Go ahead, because you really
The deck. Yeah, I do. I know. I might know a little bit about humans. So Hunter is rocking 3 Damping Spheres. 4 Oriok Champions, 3 Deputy of Detention, 2 Knights of Autumn, 1 Sin Collector, 1 Dismember, and 1 Kambal Consul of Allocation. A lot of this sideboard is built specifically either for Burn or for Phoenix. Burn, Phoenix, and Dredge is kind of what humans really cares about at the moment. Mm-hmm. And Damping Sphere will slow Vidi down as far as being able to cast multiple spells per turn, so I could see that coming in. It does affect you as well, but hopefully you land your vials is the idea, so that way you're not just casting, you're also putting cards into play. Nice. Deputy of Detention can be pretty decent because it can hit multiple Phoenixes. I would also like to see him bring in Dismember for a Thing in the Ice and then Kambal, because Kambal is just another way to punish Vidi for casting multiple spells per turn.
Yeah, and over here on Vidi's side, he has 2 Abrades, 2 Blood Moons, 1 Anger of the Gods, 1 Shatterstorm, 1 Raw. Is it Viserys?
Raw? Yeah. Is it Viceroy?
Okay. 2 Dispel, 1 Spell Pierce, 2 Surgical Extractions, 1 Rending Volley, and 2 Dragon's Claw. I can see the Blood Moons, maybe. A Braid.
Blood Moons are something that Phoenix starts to bring in against humans lately. Anger of the Braid Gods. Is something because it gets rid of the Damping Sphere and or Aether Vial, and Anger of the Gods is definitely a card that... humans tends to go wide quickly, but not necessarily big enough to live through an anger.
What about Surgical Extraction?
Surgical Extraction, I think in this matchup, you really only want to be hitting like Reflector Mage, if anything. If you bring it in, you're probably going to target Reflector Mage because that's the card that slows you down the most by bouncing your own Thing in the Ice.
Yeah, okay. Cool, nice.
But I don't know that it's really worth bringing in against humans, considering they have... so many, like, you know, there's 4 ofs of almost everything in Hunter's deck, and a lot of them just apply pressure. So really, I don't know, are there any blue red Phoenix players out there who would bring in Surgical Extraction? It is kind of a free spell because he can just pay 2 mana for it instead, so maybe it's something he brings in,
get rid of all the mana,
maybe even surgical his own whatever.
We'll see. And Vidi will be on a play here.
Mm-hmm. Again, notably.
And we're going to go ahead and do the maximum pile shuffling.
Yep.
3, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. What a lovely day for Magic today.
It's been a nice day. It's actually gone by. It feels like it's gone by quicker than it has. We've been here.
Maybe we just got used to it.
For a long time. We stopped the stream and restarted. So it says we've only been live for 17 minutes, but that doesn't count the 5.5 hours.
Yeah, that we had a break. So.
Excuse me, six hours that we had earlier.
Yeah. So thank you guys for coming back and joining us. All right. So here we go. What would be a good hand for humans?
Humans in this matchup in particular wants to see like turn 1 Vial into turn 2 Champion and Noble and or turn 2 Champion with like Thalia Guardian of Thraben. Mm-hmm. Into turn 3 Reflector Mage your Thing in the Ice, activate Vial, put in like Folly's Lieutenant or something, or it wants to have turn 1 Noble, turn 2 either Mantis Rider or Tajik and just try to race.
Yeah. Alright, we see Vidi actually mulligan his hand, and mm-hmm. I think Hunter's going to keep. Hunter looks like he has a Champion of the Perish turn 1, and he has a turn three Mantis Red or so. Mm-hmm.
Or if you just have like one or two lands and four Champion of the Parishes and a Thalia's Lieutenant, that's pretty hot too, because you're just
going huge, right?
Champion, grow other champion. Okay, attack. Champion again, and Lieutenant. You know, and suddenly you have 12 power on the board that they just have to deal with and either flip thing or basically die. But as we've seen Phoenix do before, they can cast thing and sometimes flip it like the next turn. And then just your entire game plan's gone and you're getting smacked for 7, potentially 10 or 13 damage if there's Phoenixes in the graveyard.
So actually, Hunter has a good hand. Actually, he has a turn 1 Noble. Would you play the turn 1 Noble or the turn 1 Champion of the Parish?
Looking at it here, I think you go turn 1 Champion, turn 2 either Noble or Thalia Guardian if you have it.
He's going to opt. Play.
The risky thing about... Okay, so Vidi's prioritizing his thing in the ice.
And, oof.
Vidi's going to be at 18. Hunter's still at 20.
I mean, humans, unclaimed territory.
That's Ancient Ziggurat, homie.
Oh, my bad.
Sorry, Ancient Ziggurat taps for any...
Any, yeah.
Card. Ooh, for creatures. This is pretty good. Kitesail Freebooter. Plus, take anger out of your hand.
Yeah,
dude.
What else does he have? He has Metamorphose.
Looks like a Metamorphose, and not sure what that is. That an Abrade, possibly, on the far left? I'm not sure what that is.
Don't think
we have Arc Light, Anger, Metamorphose, and something else. Obviously, you take anger because that's the thing that can kill you. Mm-hmm. Hunter's not going to swing here, not even to send a message.
Oh, was that a
that flame looks slash? Like Flame Slash.
Yeah. And he gets the anger back?
I think you Metamorphose.
Yep.
Trigger, draw. Make 2 red mana. Flame Slash.
He did hit the red, though. I mean, he hit another land, so that's pretty good. That's what he needed.
He did need a land, yes. Oh, Faithless Looting.
Okay. Nice. Oh, he's going to dump the bird.
One floating. Draws another two bird. Birds.
This is a good hand for Vidi.
Not a bad mold of 6.
No, not at all.
Flame Slash. Get my. Oh, okay. So.
6 yeah. Damage.
Swing at you for 6. Hunter's going to take it.
Nice.
Go to 14.
Ooh. I feel like Hunter's drawing a lot of land here.
He does have many lands in his hands, and that is not where you want to be with humans. Mm-mm. So territory is probably naming humans at this point, since he had 2 Ancient Ziggurats. He's going to swing in for 4.
Mm-hmm. Drops Vidi down to
14. Oop. Oh, what am I doing? What am I doing with my life?
And passes over to Vidi. Yeah,
14 all. I don't really see any way that this thing does not get flipped this turn.
I mean, did you just swing with one of the birds? Yep.
No, you swing both birds because it doesn't matter if a bird trades with a Mantis Rider, that's fine.
You could always just get it back.
I mean, if I was Hunter, I think I would make this trade here.
He's going to take it.
He's going to take it and hope that Vidi doesn't actually flip his thing. So he's going to go to 10. Oh, I'm sorry, 8. Vidi's going to wait until...
Oh, Meddling Mage, nice.
Hunter plays any more creatures. Mm-hmm. And probably mid-combat flip thing. The thing about flipping thing is that it puts both his phoenixes back in his hand, and then he's going to have to either hard cast them or have a way to put them back in his grave.
There's Meddling Mage naming.
It's a good question as to what he's naming. I imagine he's going to be naming...
Metamorphose.
There's a lot of stuff he can name. It looks like he's thinking about it, and I'm curious, and I kind of want to go ask, but I don't know if it's going to be very relevant considering how many one drops there are that Vidi could be playing to flip thing. So Lieutenant resolves, strengthening up the board. Hunter is going to attack. Here comes a lightning bolt. And it looks like Vidi's going to bolt Hunter to the face, and Hunter's just going to scoop, because at that point, Flip Thing is just going to kill him.
Yeah. That was nice.
That was pretty quick.
Really good. Pretty good by Vidi, too. He was just holding that bolt.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder what Hunter named.
I imagine, well, it wasn't Lightning Bolt, obviously, yeah. So it must have been either... either Anger or Opt Metamorphos. He might have named Faithless Looting. If I was him, I would have named something at instant speed just to try to
like a bolt.
Increase the odds of not having Thing flip on my turn.
Mm-hmm. Nice. All right. So we're getting game number three now, Vidi versus Hunter.
Mm-hmm. Interesting.
Quarterfinal match.
So for the MCQ at Magic Fest LA, I opted to try playing two Tithe Takers in my main board.
Mm-hmm. How'd that go?
And it was actually surprisingly good. Not quite good enough, mm-hmm, where I wanted it to be. But it did cause my opponents to actually have to like wait to do things or think harder about how they were going to sequence things.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to my homie Eli Loveman. He suggested maybe I just don't play Freebooter at all. I opted to keep two Freebooters in anyway. And I'm not sure. Maybe I should have just taken all the Freebooters out and played four Tithe Takers, or just played four Freebooters.
Mm-hmm.
Hunter's only playing three today.
Is he playing Tithe Taker?
He's not playing Tithe Taker, no.
Nice.
I don't actually know how good it is. I mean, I literally only played five matches of Magic with it in the deck. So
yeah.
It is a human, so it does trigger your champions and your lieutenants and everything. But I don't know. It doesn't actually do anything when it enters the battlefield. And humans as a deck, you want all your creatures to at least be doing something or benefit from your other creatures entering the battlefield.
All right, let's see here. 4, 5, 6, 7, 3, 7 Noble, Thalia's Rising, no Cavern, Reflector Mage.
It looks like he does a have good a Reflector hand. Mage. That seems
but
pretty.
It looks like he has one land. Is he? No, he has.
No, it's a Cavern, and
I think it's one land.
Is it just a Cavern? Vidi's hand looks pretty decent from what I can tell.
So you do a turn one Noble, pass.
Turn one Noble is dangerous when you're playing against a deck that has
lightning
bolts in it. Bro, speaking of the Loveman himself, saw Metal Loveman. Yeah, I agree with Hunter's decision to mulligan here. I think it's too risky.
Nice.
You know they have bolts.
Yeah.
And
he had one lander. I don't think you want to do that.
And being stuck with one land. Hunter played Freebooter and then died. That's basically what happened. Coincidence? See? Yeah. Freebooter is just not that good. Like, I wish I had stayed with Mare.
Dies to a lot of stuff.
Like, even if I kept the five-color mana base and a set of Freebooters, there were Mares in the main event, I feel like it would have been better. If I had Mares and Eidolons of Rhetoric in the sideboard main event, I think my games would have been much different.
Let's not play the what if
game. Well, I mean, touche. Good thing nobody heard you because you weren't on your bike.
Really? Let's not play that. Okay, yeah, you're right. I'm sorry.
Let's do some of this.
All right, here you go. Let's see what you got. All
right. Looking at six.
Ooh. Yeah, he's going to keep Scry.
Keeping that.
He kept the Dismember, so, I mean, that's good. Gets rid of the looking.
Yep.
I mean, gets rid of a...
Turn one champ. Here we go. Let's see if it'll live to turn two or not. Don't know if Vidi actually has a source of red mana in his hand.
Yep, he does.
Oh, he does. Okay. He can get it. Thinking about if he wants to opt or if he wants... Oh, he's got plenty of mana.
Yep. There's a Serum Visions.
It's an
arc light. Don't think you want to draw the arc light, right?
No, I don't think you want to draw the arc light. He doesn't have a bolt. But it looked like the other card was Thing in the Ice, but I'm not sure.
Yeah, he's going to arc light. Put it in the bottom.
No, they're bottom of those two cards. Yeah. Both the cards went on top of the deck, though.
Yeah. Well, you know what I mean.
I don't.
All right, my bad. Sorry. There's a noble.
There's a turn to noble. He's going to swing for three. Taking three damage here.
Going down to 17. Pass his turn. Then he draws a card. Oh, it is a Thing in the Ice.
Told you, dog.
Play the Thing in the Ice.
I can spot a thing from a mile away.
And that's the dismember there. That's pretty good.
Dismembered. This is pretty great here for Hunter. This turn might have won him the game.
Does he go down to 16?
Thing is gone.
Yeah, right.
Yes, he should be at 16 now.
Horizon. Does he drop another noble? Trigger. That's 5.
So that's 5 damage coming across. Vidi's now at 12.
He does have a bolt. So that's pretty... The bolt's pretty good.
I mean, bolt's all right. So he's going to, shoot? He'll shoot the champion, maybe. But then Hunter's got other things he could do.
I think he might have a Mantis Rider. I don't know. I wasn't so sure. But even if he does play a Mantis Rider...
He's got a Reflector Mage also, I believe.
Oh, yeah. I think
it is. Is that the only card left in his hand? I think it's Reflector Mage. Yeah.
Vidi's sweating some bullets here.
Yeah, he's definitely making Vidi sit in the tank for a second. So he's going to Faithless Looting first. Probably try to pitch or find some Phoenixes to pitch.
He's going to pitch a land and a Phoenix.
He might be deciding whether or not to keep the Phoenix in his hand and just hard cast it next turn.
And leave up a blocker or something?
Nope. All right. He's going for it. And it looks like he's going to pull the trigger on the bolt now. Bolt champion.
Nice. Yeah. We're at 12, 16.
We might see Hunter.
Gutshot. Ooh.
Okay, gut sharding is decent here. Ooh, we might see Hunter crack his canopy end of turn.
Yeah.
Hunter being a nice boy, fixing them life totals for me. Thank you, Hunter.
And Steb, you're right about the Horizon canopy.
He has less mana now, altogether, but considering he still has 3 mana represented, there's no reason to really keep the Horizon canopy around. Especially if he has
more lands. Do you reflect your mage the bird here? Yeah, right.
I don't see why you wouldn't, because he won't be able to cast it his next turn anyway. Looks like he's opting to go for damage. So that's going to be 2. Oh, yeah, sure. So that puts Vidi at 8. Because he's not dead to the Phoenix, right?
No.
Not even close. And it looks like Vidi has Island, a Braid, and something else. I couldn't tell what it was.
For 2.
Death by Noble. Oh, and here comes the Inner Braid. So we might see... What's the other card? Is that a land?
And it's a Reflector Mage.
Yeah, it's a Reflector Mage and a Cavern of Souls.
Nice.
So we'll see him bounce that now. Vidi's in some trouble here.
Was that what he drew? Yeah.
Playing his super dope island.
Yeah. What's that other card? I know it's...
It's red. It's a lightning axe.
Ooh. So he can
discard. So he has lightning axe, Arclight Phoenix, and something that looks like it's upside down. Oh no, it's just a fetch land.
Okay, he's gonna flashback Faithless Looting.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, that's really good.
So he's gonna pitch Phoenix and a land.
And a land. So he can Metamorphose.
Mm-hmm. Metamorphose, make 2 mana, draw a card.
And then Arclight.
Yep.
Yeah, and that comes back in. Nice.
I don't know if he attacks here, though.
Yeah, because that...
Oh, he can't arc light. It just got reflected. Well, no, he can pitch it and it'll... Because it's not being cast, right?
Yeah. There's the serum. As it says, you can't play it.
Return it from the graveyard to the battlefield.
Yeah.
So it's returned. It's not being cast.
Yeah.
It's pretty smooth.
Yeah, man. That's why this deck's pretty good. He also has a lightning axe. Yep.
Lightning axe. I had a bit of a lisp there for a second.
And that's a 3 damage.
He's swinging for 3.
He puts him down at 7. Right?
Yep. 7-8.
Yep. It's a pretty good match. This is a really close match here.
So Hunter needs some gas. He needs a top deck. Okay, he's just swinging in for 1.
Ooh, did he not draw anything? Ooh, no, he's drawing lands. That sucks.
It's like the curse of humans, man, I swear.
That's 3.
3 puts you to 4.
4.
Cast a Crackling Drake.
That's... Not sure where it does it, but...
So, Hunter needs like a Reflector Mage.
Nope. That's all... Looks like lands. Oh.
Deputy of Detention here.
That is a... That's a spice.
It's going to target the Crackling Drake. This is pretty decent. Swing in for 1. Put Biddy to 6. We're still playing magic here,
folks.
He's going to
opt. Hopefully hits a bolt. It actually looks... He's going to keep it, yeah. Oh, all right, nope. He just swings for 3
yeah. And gut shots you. Yep.
Nice.
Great game between Vidi and Hunter.
Nice. That was really good by both players. And now Vidi is on for his bye.
Vidi is on to the quarterfinals.
Yeah. No, semis.
Semis. This was the quarters.
Yeah, let's go.
Giant's going to go take a peek and see if there's anyone else still playing a quarter match. Peek. You peeker, Tom. You. Rip Hunter. Mazel tov, Vinny. Vidi. Plays Freebooter and dies. Rip. So how's everybody in chat doing? If you're just joining us, my name is James, aka James the Jew. I was joined just here all day today by my good friend Johnny. We see players talking about sideboards. He took out Kesig Malcontent's Tajik and 3 Phantasmal Images. Not sure if I agree with that. Tajik, I don't know if it comes out against decks that play things like Bolt and Shock, or not Shock, but Gutshot. We've had 44 players today in our Modern Collector Series event today, 6 rounds of Swiss. We are now currently in our top 8. This has been one of our quarterfinal matches.
So as of now, we have Andrew's Son and Vinny in the semifinals. We're still waiting on 2 more matches.
Okay, so Andrew's Son on Panza and Vinny have both advanced to semifinals, and we're still waiting for results from our other matches. We will be right back momentarily, folks. Try to get the next game up and running for you real quick. I need to use the restroom, so stick around. We'll be back with more magic.
All right, guys, we are actually back, and we have our first semifinal. It's between Steven versus Andrew Sun. Steven's actually on Amulet Titan, so this is the first time we're actually going to have Amulet Titan on. That's pretty good. And Andrew Sun. Who is on Bunza.
Did I miss it?
No, it's barely starting.
Did I miss the good stuff?
There you go. I don't know if I spelled it right, but yeah. All right, so here we go. We're going to start this first semifinal. What are you doing over there?
I thought I saw my pen that I lost like a week ago, but it was not my pen.
All right, here we go.
This will be interesting. Ponza versus Amulet Titan. A deck that wants to destroy your opponent's lands versus a deck that
makes a lot of lands
that try makes and kill a lot of lands hit the battlefield.
Yeah.
Gee, thanks, Tankeray in the house. We appreciate it. They're gonna like clip us or watch us and then commentate on us commentating.
Nice.
Young Steven there with a very nice sweater. Apparently, here's a little bit of info on Steven. Steven has not done laundry in about 3 months.
What?
He has that many clothes.
Really?
I'm like, dude, you're either the snobbiest, richest little Asian boy or you are the laziest dude I know and you need to go to the laundry. Like, you realize how much that laundry will cost you to do?
Oh, he told you that? Or
what? Yeah. And he was like, oh, man. Is it expensive? And I'm like, do you not wash your own? Like, do you have a washer and dryer? Like, someone's paying for it. Like,
oh, okay.
I don't know. That's funny.
Yeah. All right. Well, here we go.
Is Andrew on a mole? Or is this?
I think he's on a mole. Yeah. But that's a, let's see if we get a turn one elf.
Steven should actually be on play in this matchup. I believe he had the.
We have the.
There's a Talarian West. Tapped for Steven. Interesting turn one. I keep saying Steven. I don't remember if he goes by Steven.
Oh, I don't know. I call him Steven. That's what Will told me. He's like, his name's Steven. I was like, all right, cool.
So here's Andrew Son on the top list here versus Mr. Steven Lee.
Nice.
So yeah, this deck, this Amulet Titan deck has a lot of one ofs.
Mm-hmm.
I see a Gemstone Mine or Gemstone Mine. One of the only.
Ooh, Engineer on one. Pass his turn. And he's gonna draw here, and he drew another Arbor Elf. Plays a Stomping Ground. Ooh, Blood Moon, and.
Wow, dude, this is interesting. This is gonna be an interesting matchup.
Nice.
I tell you what.
What?
Exactly. What?
See, Steven plays a nice mountain now.
It's a hot mountain, dog.
Yeah. Three mountains now in
But he's wishing that Engineered Explosive was on three.
Yeah. Everything's a mountain now, so.
Everything is mountains.
Nice. And then now it goes up to Andrew's turn. Andrew draws a card. Plays another forest.
I believe that's an Amulet of Vigor, but I'm not sure.
Obstinate Baleth? Baleth?
Obstinate Baleth, yep. He's going to gain four life, go to 21.
Is it a tap?
Unless it's Coalition Relic? I'm not sure what that artifact is. That's
it's Coalition Relic. Remember, they're still on their first match.
Yeah, so it's a main board piece. I just don't recognize it off the top of my head. I don't know all the pieces. Yeah, indeed. Yeah.
What's it do?
Let me bring it up for everybody. Coalition Relic. You can tap it to add one mana of any color to your pool. You can tap it to put a charge counter on Coalition Relic at the beginning of your pre-combat main phase. Remove all charge counters from Coalition Relic. Add one mana of any color to your mana pool for each charge counter. And interesting piece.
Pop the Engineer Explosives on one, and he passes his turn. And now he's going to play another elf. Arbor Elf, because he has another Arbor Elf.
Who? It could. Steven could theoretically also be playing Arbor Elves, although he's not.
He's going to go ahead and swing in for...
For four.
Yep. Bring him down to 16. He's going to Stone Rain. Popping one of his lands.
Mm-hmm.
And there's another Arbor Elf. Pass his turn.
Don't sound so excited, Johnny.
No, I am. I'm just thinking, like...
Mm-hmm.
Just thinking.
This is the mind of John. This is how Johnny talks about magic in his brain.
Low-key, I do. I was just like, why is he going to do that? All right. And there's a Walking Ballista for two. Oh, and there's a... Not the Sakura Tribe Elder. It's the
No, that is...
Seeker? Tribe Seeker? Something like that.
Checking. Tribe Scout.
Tribe Scout. There you go. Oh, there's a the Maw Hellkite.
Thunder Maw Hellkite.
Yeah.
Yep. So he's going to block and before damage sack.
So this is like a good match for Andrew's son, honestly.
It's looking pretty good for Andrew here. Steven's already down to 11.
Yeah. Is it 11? I think more.
It looks like 11 to me, but I could be wrong. That might be 14.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like Steven was trying to math in his brain a little bit. I don't know if I would have let Anderson untap with that Arbor Elf. I might have chosen to shoot it once with the Walking Ballista.
Mm-hmm.
Just so that he couldn't have six mana.
Mm-hmm.
Careful with your cable, Johnny.
Sorry.
No problem.
There's the other Arbor Elf. He's going to untap it. Swing. He's going to double block the Obstinate Baleth. He still takes five. Drops down to six life. Now he plays a P and Kia. Is that P and Kia?
Yep, yeah. Sure is.
I'm not sorry, I was talking about the comedians.
No, not Key and Peele.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was going to say, I could hear the voice of William Kim somewhere saying, "You're dead, Steven."
Yeah.
You're dead.
As he goes.
Right. Gosh.
All right, here we go. Game number two. What is what are they bringing?
I bet you a bottom dollar. Steven's gonna bring in four of his Path to Exiles to shoot that Thunderbolt Hellkite down.
Yeah.
He also has two Spell Pierce, one Negate, two more Engineered Explosives, one Hornet Queen, which I would imagine that's coming in. His own Obstinate Baeloth, one Chameleon Colossus, which is a pretty cool card. One Torment Crypt, one Cavern of Souls, and one Reclamation Sage. I bet the Reclamation Sage and the Engineered Explosives also come in to try to deal with Blood Moons.
Over here on Andrew Sun's sideboard list, he has two Transfers, two Night of Autumn, four Rest in Peace, two Ancient Grunge, two Fracturing Gust, two Anger of the Gods, and one Plains. Pretty much, I see the Transfers coming in, Night of Autumn, and Ancient Grudge.
Fracturing Gust also might to try to with the Ancient Grudges to try to blow up his amulets.
Yeah, but if I drop,
it blows up all. Yeah. Of, all.
You're right.
You forget that Ponza can make the mana.
Yeah.
If Arbor Elves are out there, he can. Fracturing Gust is not a problem to cast.
So I don't think he's bringing in. He's not bringing the path in. Tell you that.
Really?
Yeah, he is. You're right. There he goes.
Yeah, what I tell you, son. Listen now, folks. I will tell you what. You will bring in the path to exile to try to hit the Thundermaw Hellcat.
Are you trying to be Bill Clinton, or are you Bill Clinton?
Little do you know my affinity for... Never mind. We won't go there. We're on Twitch. This is a family show, after all.
Oh, man.
I just want to say, Bill. Bill was a pimp. That's all I'm going to say about that.
He's a pimp?
Dude, yeah. Plays saxophone, bro.
He does?
Are you kidding? Talk about smooth...
Jazz.
Smooth jazz.
He always looks like he's happy. I think he just smokes a bunch of weed, probably.
Dude, like, I bet you he's such a super stoner. Maybe at least now that he's...
Yeah,
he's just, hasn't been president for a couple decades. I have, everybody. All right. We're mixing up celebrities here, but
yeah,
that's probably...
That was a mix of Matthew McConaughey and...
but they both got that...
Ex-President Clinton.
Southern draw.
Yeah.
Not ex. He's still referred to as President Clinton. Once you've been president, you are entitled to being called president for the rest of your life.
Really?
You didn't know that? Yeah. That's why you still say President Carter or President Bush or President Obama.
Yeah, true.
Now, the trouble that we may find out is that the other semifinal match may finish before this one is over. And if it does, then this potentially will be the last game of Magic that we get to see. Or last match, rather. Andrew Son is leading Stephen Lee 1-0 in this match. Ponza versus Amulet Titan.
Yep.
And because we do have two winners tonight, first and second place, both winning, we... probably won't get a post tournament interview. It's kind of hard to interview two people at once.
Yeah. So I was looking at these nice
Pizza Mandas.
All right, here we go. We're gonna go on. Steven's at 20. He's not at 6.
Oh, correct.
That's called unfair magic. We don't like unfair magic here, do we?
Imagine.
Steven's playing unfair magic with the Amulet Titan deck.
They're both playing unfair magic.
I don't know. Ponza's pretty cool. Ponza, you can just shut him down really
Ponza's
quick.
Ponza's mostly fair, yeah. But it still can cheat.
Anderson just throwing his cards. Like, I don't like that.
Screw this hand.
Both players are like, yeah.
I think they both respect the other person's deck enough that they know they need to have certain quality of hand.
So the final right now, it looks like it's Lafayette versus Vinny. Semi-final.
The other semifinal
looks like it's Lafayette versus Vinny.
Lafayette recently, this last Magic Fest LA, actually won himself the MCQ and qualified to go to Pro Tour London.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. It's a very interesting matchup.
Is he going?
I mean, I would assume he's going to try to go. Mm. It's not really cheap getting a passport super fast.
Yeah.
Pro Tour London's next. That's less than a month away. A little more than a month away.
Oh, yeah. That passport's going to be expensive.
Yeah, dude. It's on my birthday.
It is?
Yeah.
Are you just saying I was hoping.
No, I was hoping real bad that I would win get top 4 in the RPTQ so that way I could go to London for my birthday.
Give you a reason to go to London.
Yeah, give me a reason to go to London from Harvard.
Nice.
Be like,
do you have your passport?
I have a passport, yeah.
Okay, I need to get mine again. I think mine's expired.
We see a prime time in Steven's hand.
Nice.
Tap the lance, say go.
Here we go.
Get a little sapper leg, dude.
Turn one arbor elf. Turn one arbor elf or birds. Bop. He's going to fetch.
Don't try to sing along. It makes it worse.
Can you hear your teeth? Okay, I thought it was the only one.
No, it's part of the song. But I heard you go. You are not lo-fi hip-hop, dude. So
I am not lo-fi hip-hop. Ooh,
Utopian Sprawl. See, nice. There's part of that that way to cheat that I was talking about.
There goes that ancient stirrings. There we go.
Yeah, bam. Dude. Let's,
you think he's going to get banned? What's going to be banned over on Monday?
On Monday? Shoot, bro.
Faithless looting?
I mean, we could hope. I don't think anything will get banned.
No, I personally. Don't think so. I don't. I think it just makes people want to build more stronger.
If it sells, decks. If it sells magic cards, it's not going to get banned.
Yeah, true.
In the finals of the MCQ, he played a lady named Eliana. I don't remember her last name, and she was playing Druid Company. They played three games. I got to watch all three of them. And all three games were quite close. Both players played very well, and they both played hard matchups before getting into the finals match. Eliana on the Druid Company played blue-white control back-to-back, and that's probably its worst matchup.
Oh, man, that sucks.
Yeah.
That's a bad matchup.
Yeah. So, no offense, Lafayette, but I was rooting for her to win just because she was such an underdog.
Yeah. No, that's a real
name. Lafayette was playing Black-Green Rock.
Oh, Black-Green Rock. Mm-hmm. Oh.
And I believe he played against Burn to get into the final. I think that was the semifinals, yeah. A gentleman named Connor, I think. I think he's from the Pasadena area. I think I've seen him before.
I think
so. The whole top four was all SoCal people as well.
Nice.
Oh, Blood Moon.
There it is. I would have just conceded to her. If I'm not gonna go to England, you know.
I mean, I know he wanted to go. Oh, okay. So it's not like Lafayette doesn't want to go.
Yeah.
I would have considered. If I didn't have a passport and knew how much it would cost to get an expedited passport, I probably would concede to her too.
Yeah, I would concede to her. Like, you want to go? Go ahead. Just give me a
Tyler's tracker. That's pretty hot. No, yeah, you can't do that. You can't say give me something and I'll concede. That's cheating.
I didn't say that. You said it.
You were going to say it.
No. So cheating.
Steven loading up his ballista to shoot down the walker.
And we're gonna see.
And then attack for one.
Oh, yeah.
Shoot down the walker. Shoot down the tracker.
Yeah, we're getting like really. We're
getting zoned in. Zoned out.
Well, yeah. Yeah.
It's been a long day, folks.
That's what it is. It's just been a long day. Look, it's already 1 hour gone.
It's been a while.
Ooh, Chandra. Nice.
Chandra's pretty dope here. Question is what is Andrew going to do with Chandra? He's going to choose to draw a card, discard it, and shoot Steven. Kerkraw. You're the Holland player that you and I played? True name one. Shout out to you, my friend. How are you doing?
Oh, Primetime gets dropped.
Yeah, funny thing about Primetime, and we saw Steven prioritize getting basics earlier off of his Ancient Stirrings and his Tribe Scout.
Nice.
Steven, I think, is at... Steven's at 16?
Yep, and he's going to go ahead and draw a card. Anderson draws a card now. Sorry.
Getting more lands out of his deck with the prime time.
Oh, nice.
What was that SS, Johnny? Booty Snatcher wants to know.
Huh?
So you went 4-0. Did you just lose afterwards both?
Super spicy shutout. Nah.
Ooh. Battle of the Titans. Let's go.
One to you and one.
Yeah.
Rest.
In response, he'll sack off the target.
Yeah. Hey, yo, this is a Titan match.
In a world where Titan battles Titan.
Swing, dog, swing.
To advance into the finals.
I want to know what life totals are. Is it 16-14?
It is 16-14. That is correct. I can see him over here in the sub camera.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Hey, man.
I just figured it out, bro. Smart on me. We've been doing this for months now. I'm like, we can't see the lives.
Man, volley.
So Steven does decide to enter combat and swing, triggering prime time.
He's gonna block.
Getting two lands. Are they both 6/6s? I think so.
Yeah. Yep, they're gonna trade here. Nice.
The question is who has more Titans in their deck? We know there are four prime times, primeval Titans in Steven's deck. But in Mr. Andrew Song's deck, there are only two Infernal Titans.
I think you should just plus here.
Oh, plus Chandra?
Yeah.
Yeah, probably. Plus Chandra.
Nice. Two damage. Yeah, you don't want those lands right now. They're worth nothing right now, especially because Blood Moon's out.
Dude, is this in second? Oh, it's the Thundermaw Hellkite.
Nice.
Savage.
And
Steven's down to 9.
And Steven doesn't look like he's... Oh, is that a Summoner's Pack? You can't even pay for it. Oh, you can. He can.
Yeah, he can.
Do they even run Summoner's Pack?
Yeah, yes.
They do.
Yes, they do. Because sometimes they get other stuff, too.
Yep. You're right.
So, Amulet Titan, turns out, makes you do a lot of math.
Yeah. Johnny doesn't like math.
Ponza, not as much.
It is a Summoner's Pack. Okay. So, does he play the Summoner's Pack?
I mean, I think he has to if he wants to live. But at the same time, he needs to find a way to answer the Hellkite. Otherwise, he could just be dead next turn if the Hellkite swings and if Andrew has lightning bolts to shoot.
Mm-hmm.
Or just Chandra. Chandra's a pretty big problem here. Sadly, these matches are not timed. We could be here all night. Steven could just be sitting there flicking his three basic forests back and back and back. Lost to blue-white midrange round 5 with Resto Angel and Wall of Omen. Surgicals and rips. Then drew round 6 for tickets. I think Steven had a deep run with Amulet in the Grand Prix. Yeah, I think Steven ran pretty good with that. He day 2'd, and I'm not sure how far he got as far as like prizing and whatnot.
Oh, Reclamation Sage popping that. That's actually pretty good.
Now he's going to pop Tolarian West, probably get an Engineered Explosives.
Summoner's Pack.
Get another Summoner's Pack.
Get a Primetime.
Confused. So he's played two Summoner's Packs now?
Yeah. So how much does he have to pay?
Well, it enters the battlefield, so now two more lands. So trigger. There's going to be two more lands. He doesn't have an amulet out, so he can't get the hasty vigilance little combo, right?
Yeah.
Question is which lands is he getting? Because he needs to be able to... pay for his packs.
Can he get any lands? He's trying to go for the win. Yeah.
Let's see, I need to actually hold his deck list so I can try to see what he's going for here and what combo of
lands.
Cards.
Okay.
Sure, I get that Booty Snatcher, but the thing is all those lands enter tapped and he doesn't have, I guess he has bounce, like, so they, Interesting. Okay. So he's choosing to attack Andrew. This is kind of nerve-wracking.
Fetches goes down to 12, right?
Yeah, now this fetch lands are active again. So Steven has two pack triggers to pay for, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Not just one. Dude, if Andrew can find another blood moon.
He loses, yeah.
It'd be pretty hot.
All right, blood moon, here we go. He should plus.
Well, he could plus Chandra and see if. Or just play a second Thundermaw Hellkite in the air, and you're just dead.
Wow,
Andrew deck. Sun.
The master himself, Andrew Sun, takes this with a top deck Hellkite and win. Nice.
Dude.
He's going to do it. He's in the final.
He's in the finals, so Andrew secures himself an invitation.
Wow.
We'll go see if we can snag the other match, if it's even still going. Johnny's going to go find out, folks. So I'll still hang out right here. That was a very interesting match to watch, in my opinion. Anyway, there's paths. Never found a path. RIP. What's up, chat room? How's everybody doing? True name, were you here tonight? You weren't here tonight, were you? I've been back in the booth most of the evening, so I can't tell who was here and who wasn't here. Unless they were on the feature match. Well, if you're just joining us, this was one of our semifinal games being played out between Stephen Lee and Andrew Sun. Not sure why Andrew Sun's last name is actually up there. Normally we don't put last names, but that's fine. Amulet Titan versus Ponza. It was a very interesting and kind of close two games. The other six decks, yes, let me go over that. So there was five color humans, blue red phoenix, mono red phoenix, it looks like. Let me see here, just double checking. Yeah, mono red phoenix, blue red phoenix, Ponza, Amulet Titan. Sorry, the pages are freshly printed, so they're a little stuck together. Green Tron. Another blue red phoenix. So two blue red phoenix, one mono red phoenix. And lastly, blue-white control. Vidi already was on earlier with in a quarterfinals match. He beat humans with his blue-red phoenix. Not sure if it's going to be of the other two. The other semifinals match right now, I believe, is Lafayette Kinsey on blue-white control versus Vidi Vieja on blue-red phoenix. So I think Johnny is out there right now trying to see if they're still playing, if we can get them to the feature table, etc., etc. Let's see. So you're all probably tired of hearing this at this point, but just so you all know, next week we have our March standard collector series qualifier. You can come on down and play versus many other opponents to attempt to qualify for our 5K Invitational in 2020 with Standard. The week after that, we have our Legacy event. Same process, CSQ event, where you can qualify for $5,000 prizing paid out into the top eight only. Really looking forward to that. So far, we have, I think, one repeat winner. So basically, what you can do is you can earn an invitation on your first win in one of these events, and you can qualify up to twice more, which qualifying an additional time earns you effectively a bye in the 5K tournament itself. So you can win up to two byes in the 5K tournament. So it's structured very much like a Magic Fest. And after the two byes, you can't win more than two buys, but there will be X amount of rounds of Swiss depending on how many players there are. Cut to top eight, same as it ever was. And then after that, the top eight will be allocated prizing of $5,000 divvied up and however they decide to do the prize structure. Not sure. I imagine first place will have the most and eighth place will have the least. It's typically how it goes. But until then, we're just sitting here hanging out. I'm going to switch over to my face screen. Cheese. And just kind of sit here and chat with you guys until we find out if we're going to have another game of Magic to feature or if that's it. Lafayette and Vidi may already be in game three. They're in game two right now. Vidi is up one. Yes, that's pretty good for Vidi. Not so good for Lafayette. I guess if there's a game three, I think we'll be getting them over. If Vidi ends up winning the second game, then that will probably be it, because I doubt that Andrew and Vidi will want to actually play any more Magic since they don't need to, since they're both going to be winners today. Anyone out there in chat have any questions, comments, concerns they would like to present to the board? As far as anything, I don't know. What do you guys want to talk about in the meantime? I'm going to say a hard no on, like, I don't know. I guess you could ask anything and then I'll just say yes or no if we're going to answer that or not. Pardon me while I drink a little water. Going 4-0 with Dredge. That's pretty dope, True Name. Pretty dope indeed. I ended up going 3-2-1 in the MCQ. I think. I might be mixing up things. I don't know. The last round opponent offered to split with me, and I said I'd like to play for it for the ticks, you know, and he said sure. And as we were playing, turns out he was actually friends with one of our teammates and friends in Small World. They went to school in Washington, D.C. together. And then after he thoroughly squashed me, he was on Blue Red Phoenix and I was playing humans. He still offered to split anyways. Super cool guy. So shout out to my dude. Yeah, it was fun. Magic Fest was fun. I probably spent way too much money, more than I needed to. I'd been playing so much standard Magic prior to that I was pretty rusty with Modern, and I probably should have either tried to grind more Modern beforehand or maybe just not played the main event and just done side events. But that's how the cookie crumbles sometimes. Y'all quiet out there. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Did Randy come back? Anyone know?
He
Big Booty Snatcher, did Randy come back, or was he too salty that I accidentally banned him and did he, like, run away or something? He probably went to work. Me and Johnny thought about calling him up, seeing if he was at work, being like, hey, man, how about that free pizza? But then Johnny was like, no, dude, you probably hurt his feelings when you banned him. Apologies, Randy. I'm sorry. You can wear your one shirt next time I see you, but, like, people can see through your shirt or whatever if you want to. Randy's got this, like, semi-translucent shirt he wears a lot. Big Booty Snatcher knows what I'm talking about. I still should have asked for the pizzas. Thought about it. I was in the mood for Chinese, though, and got Chinese anyways. It was super good. Pizza, pizza. Man, I could be out there watching this game, letting you guys know. Like, if I leave the chat, if I leave stream running, I guess I could commentate in the chat. That's a lot of effort, though, and typing with my fingers. My thumbs are a little too big for my phone. I need a new phone. It's really interesting now, a little side conversation and distract from Magic, how phones went from being, let's get our phones as small as we can, to let's make them as large as we can in like less than 10 years. Like, it just circled around. I think it's interesting. Human beings can't decide what they like and what they don't like. See, what can I find to make noise here in this back room? Here's some nice plastic. I don't know if we have stereo. Are the mics set up in stereo, guys? This one always sounds so louder and more crisper. I don't know if the gain's probably just higher than on mine. Actually, I can see it is. The Zoolander phone. Exactly. Where it's just like, hello. Now I'm sitting here on Twitch all by myself. Is it? I mean, it can be. If you send me a tip right now, we can do some ASMR. I don't know. That's fine. Did you win yet? Absolutely. SoCal Sal, you win everything. All the prestige, all the prizing. Dude, pack opening ASMR, that is smart. All right, I bet you a lot of nerds would be super into that if I, like, described how it smelled and slowly shuffled the cards from the common to the rare to find out what the rare was. And what the... There's nothing quite crackles like a magic pack. My shoulder on the mic? That's a little difficult. If I go like this, I guess. Doesn't really work very good, I don't think. I'm trying to see if I can get Johnny to come give me an update here, but I don't think he's paying attention to his phone. Johnny, update. See if we can get Johnny to be infield correspondent. Oh, I see Jake Harris setting up the table. Perhaps there's going to be a game 3 between Vidi and Lafayette. Maybe. Maybe. Not sure yet. All right, no one sat at the table yet. I'm looking at the camera feed now, and it's still empty. Yeah, I'll message Randy right now about free pizzas. Be like, saw, dude. Saw, dude. How about them za? See what he says. What kind of response? He might not know he's not banned anymore. Low-key felt kind of bad because I did not mean to ban him. I was just trying to time him out for a second because I thought it would be funny. Still no action at our feature table. Waiting to see what happens. Message the guy. I did. I sent him a Facebook message. It even shows that he's online, or that he was online. He might have turned it off now that I messaged him. Indeed. Oh, you want to know why Johnny's not responding to me? Because look what's right here. Johnny's phone and my phone. Oh, man, my phone. That's not my phone. That's Johnny's phone. This is my phone. It's got a hole in it. Sad face. Send a tip in chat to help me pay for a new phone screen. Just kidding. Don't do that. It's fine. I'll break my new phone screen in just a minute. Do. All right, I need to message someone else. Apparently, I can message Jake. Jake, update me on the game. In the meantime, maybe let's find some other royalty-free tunes. How about royalty-free rap? Let's see what this list is. This playlist is currently empty because it doesn't exist. Oh, got me. Hip-hop, rap, pop tracks, beats, and instrumentals for demos royalty-free. Let's check it out. So far, nothing's happening. Did I turn it down too much? Excuse me, I just burped a little. That was rude. Jake hasn't seen the message yet. RIP. It's really quiet out there, like super quiet. Am I alone? Did everyone leave the store and I'm the only one here? Seems entirely possible. Where is this playing and how come it's not playing for me? Is this an ad? I don't understand life right now, guys. Sorry that this is great content I'm producing. Amazing content. Fantastic content. So, let's just go back to our library. How about tra-la-la Keanu Reeves? Oh, that's Logic. Some 80s rock? I got some death metal. Some, how about D&D ambient music? Or punk. Some punk music sounds good. Let's see what this is all about. Ill Snare. Welcome, Ill Snare. Sexy is a strong word. I don't think that is entirely applicable, but sure. Thank you. Is that too loud? Might be too loud. It's a little loud for my personal ears, but that's fine. No one is listening to me or updating me on what the heck is happening out there. Play some Misfits? I don't know if I can. I don't know if I can play this song. I need to look at rules and regulations for music. I think there's rules now, and you can't just play whatever you want. So we'll continue with the stuff titled Royalty Free and see if we can... But then that stuff doesn't want to play. I don't know. I don't know how this works yet. I need to do some reading. There you go. Alright guys, I'm going to be right back in just a moment, try to figure out what in the hoo-ha hanny is going on, so just a moment, be right back. The lights turned out, I've been sitting here so long, what the actual heck, alright.
I got lost. Why are we playing Misfits, dude? Come on.
It was requested.
Oh, my God.
You don't like Misfits?
Dude, I don't want to get into that. All right. So, sorry it took a while. We were watching the match. When it looked like we couldn't stream it. Vidi was only 8 cards away from being decked out.
He had 2 cards left in his deck.
2 cards. Sorry, 2.
When I walked over just now to the table, there were 2 cards left in his deck. But he was able to get 3 Phoenixes out and also bolt Lafayette for the win.
Yeah.
So it is Vidi with Blue Red Phoenix and Andrusan on Panza who go to the finals. However, because first and second both win invitations, they're saying we don't want to play any more Magic. So sadly, that is it for tonight. There will be no more Magic to be viewed. Although they do have to determine which person is the actual winner getting first place and which gets second. One will probably just say, okay, I concede because it's really irrelevant at this point.
But also, Vinny and Andrewson already won their invitation, so now they actually get their buys.
I think they are the second and third contenders to both win a buy. And so we now have three contenders in our qualifier coming up who have buys. That is correct. Mm-hmm. SoCal Sal. Shout out to SoCal Sal. You guys, he streams Magic quite a bit on both MTGO and Arena. Go check out his channel. Give him a follow if you like watching Magic. He mm-hmm. he plays a lot of Magic online as well. Mazel tov to Vidi and to Andrew. Mm-hmm. Little bummed we're not going to get to watch any more Magic. A little stoked that we don't have to watch any more Magic and we can go now.
Yeah, I think we had a fair enough... Sorry, I think we had a fair enough amount of Magic today.
I've had to do this all day. Like,
yes.
Wherever his mouth is.
I think like, I just need to get the mic that's already in the headset so I can...
That would be more beneficial yeah. for you. Yeah.
But yeah, overall, I think we had great Magic today.
We did. We saw some great Magic today.
Yeah, it was fun. Yeah, but make sure you guys catch us next Saturday for Standard.
Standard.
Are you going to be in it? Are you going to play it?
I think I might play in it.
Oh, yeah. That's fine. That's
not
fine.
Sure.
No, that's cool, man.
Might commentate also if nobody else is around to commentate or mm-hmm. unable to. A couple last closing announcements. We've said it many times before. Next Saturday is our CSQ Standard event. The weekend after that will be our CSQ Legacy event. You can pre-register for both of them right now. Mm-hmm. You can follow us on social media at Collector Legion or / Collector Legion on any social media that you have. Check mm-hmm. out our website, collectorlegion.com. There are multiple blogs and articles about things that we like to talk about on there, as well as the store itself has a shop through TCG Player that you can purchase stuff from us should you need. We got cool dad hats like that. I'm not wearing any collector gear at the moment.
You get a Collector Legion beard.
You get yourself a collector. No, that's all natural. You got to spend some time on that one.
Yeah.
Come play Magic weekly. We also have
weekly events.
Things like Dungeons and Dragons and tabletop games available. People come play Dragon Ball Super as well as Star Wars and other games like that. Trying to think if there's any last announcements.
Wednesdays we have Modern.
Mm-hmm.
On Friday we have FNM, and then Saturday we do our CSQs.
Monday we have Standard Showdown.
Yep.
Tuesdays is Commander. Yep. And then Thursdays, you forgot about it, is Legacy.
Oh, Thursday is Legacy. Sorry.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, all right. I think it's going to wrap it up for today, though.
I think that's it. Both our winners declined hanging out with us in this tiny, cramped space because it's tiny and cramped, and, and they're done.
I think everyone's just tired.
Everyone's
been
pretty
here
tired
for
right
over
now.
2 hours. Yeah. I mean, more over than 2 hours. I've been here for like at least.
Maybe your brain's only been here for 2 hours.
Yeah.
But I know I've been here for much longer than 2 hours.
Yeah.
So with that, we're going to sign off, folks. We'll probably let our little slide play for a little bit before we actually completely shut down the stream. But thanks for stopping by. Again, follow us on everything. We're glad you came by and hung out. And until then, play more games.
Goodbye, guys.
Peace.
Take care.